definitely add more shadows in this area here in a minute because this is all light. Now, for some reason, my paint today is a little thin, and I think it's because of this. I didn't use that much. Oh, I also used another medium in it. I bet that's what did this. Usually my paint's a lot thicker than this. I do very high impasto painting. In other words, you can feel this painting literally when it's finished. Cover up this white right now. So now I need to come back through here and start forming up this stuff. And that's when I come into the different tints of the colors like I was doing earlier. So this red's going to turn into more of a pink at this edge. And we will slowly mixing up some Azuria red that I'd cut, and now I've got it mixing with Payne's gray to give it that darker red for shadows. You got to give your picture, your painting, whatever you're doing, even drawing, you got to give it depth by giving it some shadows. Which I'm gonna have to add some more in these. Barely has anything. So Is this abstract art? Yes, in a way it is. Even though after I'm done with it, you will be able to tell what it is. It has abstract qualities to it. I call it contemporary impressionism or essence painting. It's when I try to feel what that painting really feels, or what that scenery looks like or feels like to me, and try to paint a feeling, which is probably one of the hardest things to do. Always think of Echo of a Scream. If you've never seen that piece of artwork, you gotta check it out. Echo of a Scream. How do you paint a scream? I'm not gonna give you too much information about it. If you want to, just go and check it out. All right, so I gave that some depth. Let's get this one going. So why do you not want to use just black to make it dark? Well, for one thing, when you're working with a palette knife, you use black. It will start to dirty up your painting. And that's not what you want in a palette knife painting. Start dirtying it up and it's going to be ruined. Let me go ahead and go back here for a few minutes. So I'm going to switch knives here, get one little spot, because I need a much smaller edge. I don't see my edge. If I am at a point and I see something else, I'll switch and go to it. That's what I just saw here. So some more white. So my paint usually doesn't look as bad as this one, but But they come in these large tubes. Probably the color I use the most of course, would be white. You do so much tinting. And mixing up some more this sort of pinkish. Set this apart. Another one. Trying to be careful as I go through not to erase some of my shadows I've already created. changing the tint of the same orange that I had mixed up. Making it lighter again to keep adding a little bit more to each one I do. When I do it, I try to load up mostly just one side and pull it down into the sides. I need a lot lighter than that. I can see this place in my mind for the life of me, but I have no idea where it was that it made me think of this. I think it was out at Shelby Forest. One fall when I went out there to take some pictures. I want to say that's from one of those pictures gave me that idea, because it was like yellowish, and then I had that whitewash as it went back, and then it got green up on one side, was still not changing colors. So I believe that's what it was. I have to go back through my old photographs, figure out if that was the one that made me think about this. Squint my eyes, I can see the value changes a lot better, but your eyes get adjusted to value too easy if you and it'll make it where it's hard to see. It's like if you looked at a pattern on a floor for 10 minutes, a very tight pattern, and you looked away, you would still see that pattern on whatever it is you're looking at. If you have that problem where it's hard to see the value changes in what you're working with, if you take a picture of it and put it into your computer, or laptop, whatever, or even your phone, turn it to black and white, and then you can really see what your value changes are. Like, I still got a lot of work to do with these. Darker to there. More white. Oh, that wasn't white. I really messed up. So I thought I grabbed my white. Nope, I grabbed my impasto gel. Okay, I guess we're going to use that with my white. Doesn't really matter. Doing high impasto anyhow, so. Just squirted out a lot of it. Again, if remember, if you can, to check on older people. They are generally the ones that are not going to ask for help. Make sure they have all the supplies they need. Somebody can go out and help them. Please help them. I've been constantly checking on my relatives, making sure everybody's okay. So I need to add a little green, even though this is my yellow area, I need to add green in little areas because there's going to be some of those things that are not turned yet. We are dealing with like a fall scene here, so even though it's not one that you would see normally in nature, but I don't paint what you can see in nature. If you want nature, go out and take a photograph. That's why they made the camera. I like to paint my mood, my feeling. Most of mine comes from Christmas time with the bright lights back in the 70s and 80s. A reflection of lights off the tinsel hanging off the Christmas tree. That's where a lot of mine comes from. Made a very dark green just to add some depth. Then I'll come back over it with the yellows. Sorry, sometimes I get really quiet. It's very hard for me to talk while I'm doing this. I usually can go through an entire painting and never say a word. Mainly because I'm the only one in my studio, and that would make me look a little crazy if I was talking to myself. Now, somebody was to peek in my studio, hear me talking and don't see anybody, be surprised they come and take Mr. Bowers away to the insane asylum. I want to make sure, because this is going to be one of the closest to me trees, that I really get this nice and layered, nice and thick. Let's see. Let's break up this. Let's make it come over like that. And I don't like this spot like that. All right. All right, I'll revisit these here in just a little bit. Do one more adjustment. Using the very tip right now because this is further away, so I don't want big squared areas. All right, so now we're going to, let me change out these gloves real quick.